something went on here, something went on there. And
this time on TNT.
Our dad's play hit the post.
And we went tobogganing in Pembroke.
And the sourdough scandal of 2019. That's all coming up right now on TNT.
Happy New Year, Bob.
Happy New Year, Bob.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year, bud!
Merry Christmas!
First pod Everything. Of 2019.
Yes.
Are you
yes,
a guy so that much. The 2nd of January you want to see no more lights up on people's houses, or do you like to let it ride as long as possible?
Well, because I don't mind the vibe of a Christmas tree in the house, so right, it's still up. It's still going.
Is
right
it?
Now. Yeah, it's still banging. The three banger is still banging.
Is it real or fake?
It was fake this year.
Yeah. First year with a faker?
I think we're do like every couple years fake and then a real one to switch it up.
So then what do you do with the fake
you
one
guys?
On the years that you get a real one? Just stays in the box?
Well, well this time we just kind of, because the house was up for sale, right? And then you have showings and stuff like that.
Oh,
so
yeah, needles everywhere, forget it.
You don't, well, no, not even that. You just don't want it to look too Christmassy when you're, you know, trying to sell the house.
Right.
So we just kind of keep it really minimal, but we took the house off the market for a little while and then put it back up in a bit, but yeah, I think in the spring. But so now that that it's off, we just got a Christmas up in here big time. And so now it's I think it's good because you look around at night and you just look at the tree and it's all our tree. Every single ornament is like the kid made it from the past, or it's been on there. So there's so many memories with everything. You just kind of, it's never going to be let's get that thing out of here. You know what I mean?
I am in the basement in the office, and in the interest of pursuing natural light, I faced the window and it was cloudy when we started. And now the sun came out, and I look like a ghost.
You look like the
Casper,
sun.
Casper, the friendly mask.
Are you actually?
Gore, gore, gore,
all I see is the sun.
It's so harsh.
It's like Teletubbies, the baby. Right, the sun is the baby's face. Or there's that one. If you know, if you see the Christmas Carol, the Jim Carrey animated one.
Yeah.
Did you see that one? There's a character.
Oh my gosh,
that
you can't
guy.
Even see my face at all.
Right? That's
and
totally
my hair.
The character.
There was a conductor of the Halifax Symphony named Georg Tintner. And that's who I look like, exactly. Oh wait, cloud cover over the sun, I'm back.
Oh no, here he comes.
That's like the That's like the Expos Jams walk-up mic when it went crazy and started doing reverb by itself. Oh, there I am. Sun. I'm back.
The sun literally passed across your eyeballs
I
and
know.
Face and you became it.
That was so weird. It's like I was fading. So
I like that.
In the days before Christmas, we went to Nashville. And I had a few firsts. It was my first NFL game. We went to see the Tennessee Titans and the Washington Redskins.
Nice. How was that?
It was fun. Americans, as you know, go all in for their teams and for their sports in a way that I think reserved Canadians do not. Like, obviously, 100,000 people show up for a... Oh, I might be disappearing again. 100,000 people show up for a college football game.
And then there's 150,000 outside hanging out.
Yeah. So, Indy and I...
Did you have some tailgate parties?
A little bit. Indy and I got in the elevator in our hotel, and there was a sizable gentleman, like, well, I know, 6'6" and 395 pounds.
Like a linebacker style.
Well, I suspected he was a football player, but I didn't want to make any generalizations. Oh man, this is so sunny.
This is
so
it's like it goes back to just the gut, you know, the spirited speech.
Yeah. What day is it?
You're back again.
So this sizable gentleman's in the elevator. I didn't want to make assumptions about who he was or what he was doing. So I said, "What brings you to town?" And he kind of laughed that I wouldn't know who he was or what he was doing there. And he said, "Oh, I'm playing football." And I was like, "That's great. I'm going to the game. I'll see you there." Which I realized in hindsight was probably not true.
I'll see you on the field.
He was Morgan Moses is his name, number 76 on the Washington Redskins. And he was, what was the movie with Sandra Bullock? Was it called Blindside?
The Blind Side, yeah.
He was...
He's one of those guys, that big?
Well, yeah, in the gentle giant sense. And he was wearing like a $50,000 suit and had a $48,000 leather overnight bag. Like one of those guys, like... Obviously, you're not buying that at the Big and Tall store. It was custom fit and whatever, but he was extremely respectful and a total gentleman. Mm-hmm. And it was great. Except I love that the people sitting all around us... By the way, we bought the tickets on StubHub. We bought upper bowl kind of nosebleed tickets. This has never happened when I bought tickets through StubHub. Got an email from them saying, "Oops, the tickets that you bought have actually been sold elsewhere. But don't worry, we found you new seats, and I think you'll like them." Never had that happen before. So we went from being like second top row in the upper bowl to eight rows from the field. Ah, woo,
woo. So you got swank seats.
Swank like seats that. Around all the season ticket holders.
Wow.
So people go to these games every week and become friends with the season ticket holders around them. So there are people that you would not expect to be hanging out together and buds, but everyone's high-fiving each other like anytime something happens. And people shout the same things throughout the game. The woman behind me was yelling, "Get him!" Just pretty consistently throughout the whole game. Wasn't clear who was to be gotten or what for. She was just yelling, "Get him!" And then
get him.
E-E-M. Get him! The running back on the Tennessee Titans, his name is Henry. That's his last name. I was trying to find a little football jersey for him with his name on it so I could give it to Henry. And every time he was on the field, they were like, "Let the big dog eat!" And everyone around seemed to be shouting that thing. Like, they're all... It's like going to see... what's the musical where everyone participates and throws toasts and stuff? Yeah, everybody knows the verbal cues and they know what to do. Anytime it's first down, everyone goes, "Ooh, ooh." I can't remember the last time I was a part of something that big. But I have to confess, like where all the people are doing the same thing at once. And I felt a little left out, but I felt totally included. The guy in front of me was extremely enthusiastic. And at one point... he turned around to high-five everyone in our section, and I'm ashamed, but I stared at the floor, and I didn't make eye contact because I felt shy. I denied him the high-five because I felt weird about it. Not great, weird. Right?
Yeah. Well, I went to a Buffalo Bills game one time and experienced their tailgating, which is more like extreme wrestling and stuff.
Really?
There's people jumping off the tops of vans onto tables, onto guys, like, just for
kicks. Well, see, that sounds fun.
Well, it's fun to watch, yeah. Someone's gonna die doing that one of these times, but...
It's that wild, huh?
Yeah, it's crazy. Buffalo gets a little out of hand. I don't even know what you call that. That's more beyond tailgating. That's extreme tailgating.
The thing that surprised me is how quickly the Titans fans went from... "Here we go, boys, this is it, it's gonna be awesome," to turning on the team.
Oh, yeah.
And there was one guy behind me who was shouting hyper-specific, well, they're actually kind of broad, like, "Just try being good at football."
Oh, yeah.
Like one of those guys.
A guy
try to get the ball in the end zone.
Guy who can barely sit up and stand.
Yeah. He's yelling like, that stuff at
get
them.
Get! Learn how to throw!
So between, get him! And let the big dog eat. And try holding on to the football. It was pretty, it was an entertaining cacophony.
How was the pace of the, like, as soon as the gate, like, this play stops, does it go to some madness, like, big race? There's, you know, these
like potato sack races and stuff?
Yeah, or all of a sudden, like, you know, some huge explosion happens in the jungle,
yeah, there was,
or whatever.
There was lots of stuff to entertain the people, and it was close to Christmas, so there were lots of stilted, my name's so-and-so, want to wish everyone a nice, a Merry Christmas. Like, those pre-recorded, the players are like...
Have you ever noticed how sometimes those are getting out of hand? Like how there's not 1 second without something going on?
Oh, yeah, it was nuts.
You just can't have, like, just sitting and maybe having the players doing whatever and on the field. There's got to be some event.
High school marching band.
Just kicks in.
People rolling barrels, guys trying on helmets. Yeah, there was a lot going on. But it was
people
fun.
Getting arrested.
It was fun. Yeah. I was really glad I went because that was, you know, something I'd always wanted to do, go to an NFL game. I think a Packers game is the one I'd really like to see. Because that's fan-owned, right? Isn't the venue fan-owned?
Well, yeah. I think you, if you're a season ticket holder, you're one of the you're invested in it. In
yeah.
Regard.
But if it snows, don't the fans show up and shovel it off? Shovel off the field together?
Oh yeah, no. Well, because that's it. The town is the team. Like the support is so extreme there that everybody is voluntarily involved or just a fan. That's kind of the same thing, I guess. There.
Right.
I've played shows there, and it's just you drive in there, and that's it. It's like this is the Packers, cheese, and the Packers.
I can't remember if I've ever told you this.
Packing,
I was working on a TV show.
Cheese, packing seats. Packing Lambos.
Is that what it's called? Lambo. Oh, there we go.
Lambo Field.
Yeah. I was working on a TV show called The Kids Are in Charge, and every town we went to, we had to buy the tackiest tourist souvenir, and one member of the crew had to wear it in the next town. Did I ever tell you this? And we found a T-shirt in Wisconsin.
I don't think so.
That said, Wisconsin, where farting is considered a sport. And the dot over the I in fartin' was a wind cloud.
Yeah.
That's a nice T-shirt.
That. Couple wolves howling styles.
Yeah.
So I went to Pembroke over the after Christmas.
How was the Brook?
New Year's. It's great. It was amazing. It was a little chilly, but it was minus 25 on a couple days. We did have a day or two of nice weather. It was like plus 4, and we went sledding at Mother's Hill by the old hospital. I think it was a nunnery back in the day.
Of course, but, it was
just a beautiful, perfect hill for tobogganing. Like super long, not too steep. Kids just got right into things. We went there twice. It was a highlight.
Do you know,
tobogganing was a great time.
We've done it a few times this winter too. We should ask the buds to share with us the hot toboggan spots in their respective towns.
Yeah.
So we can put together a map of, like, if you find yourself in Wolfville, you have to go here. Because in Truro, it's the Legion.
Oh, yeah?
The Legion Hill, that's where you go.
Where are your hot toboggans? Give us your hot toboggans.
Hashtag hot toboggans, plural.
Yes.
Let us know where your hashtag hot toboggans are.
Yeah. Let's see the best hill. There's a couple around here. There's one right at the school at what my kids call Big Park. There's a steep side, and then there's a really insanely steep side with like old school goal posts, like iron soccer goal posts. So like kids are getting hurt or anybody going near there. It's one of those things that's like a magnet as soon as you're on the sled.
Like in a Will Ferrell
dangerous
movie, he would straddle the goal post.
Yeah, oh
down
yeah.
On a crazy carpet.
Sure. Yeah.
Racing
that's,
John C. Reilly.
Bruno's brother, Dan Gerussi. Dan Gerussi.
Oh, Dan Gerussi.
Dan Gerussi.
Here's
don't
a weird
that
one.
Hill. It's, don't go down that hill. It's Dan Gerussi. Dan Gerussi.
I've seen that girl before. It's so Dan Gerussi.
Gerussi.
Dan
Gerussi.
Here's a weird one. Dan. And I would like to ask the buds about their feeling on this, too. Shug likes a specific type of sourdough bread, right?
Nice. That's interesting. She's got, what do they call it? when they're trying things that is
an adventurous palate.
Yeah, my kids are a little bit, well, Jack's the most adventurous and John is the most non-adventurous, to the point where he won't touch ketchup or mustard styles,
Indy eats condiments. About three things and that's it. But
okay,
for some reason,
sourdough bread.
Shug is really into the sourdough bread, and it's made at a small bakery here in town. But it is sold at a couple of other places around town as well, but it's kind of hard to come by.
What's the deal?
And it's a small bakery, so they don't make that many loaves.
But it's just specifically sourdough bread. It's not a
country sourdough.
Yeah.
And she loves it, and it is really good bread. Like, I don't know, it's kind of like sawdust and glue, like one of those types of bread.
All right.
So I call the other day, right? And I say, my name's Jonathan. I'd like you to hold a couple loaves of country sourdough. I first asked, do you have any? And she said, yeah, there's a couple loaves here. And I said, would you mind? I'm on my way in town. Could you set those aside and put my name on them? She said, sure, no problem whatsoever. So I go to the store within an hour and I say, hi, my name's Jonathan. I'm here to pick up the loaves of bread that you set aside. And she says, what? It's the weirdest thing. Someone else named John was just in here and said there are two loaves of sourdough for him, and he bought them.
Did it sound like sketchy a little bit?
To me, it did.
Yeah.
Statistically, mathematically, what are the odds that someone would have come in that short time between me calling and me going in, A, with their name Jonathan, and B, that they happened to have a couple of loaves set aside? I feel like she was fibbing.
How long had it been since you called again?
46 minutes.
Yeah, I think she was just kind of caught, maybe, and then that she had to say that.
I also think...
What would you do, like, if you by mistake, or you thought they're not coming, or you
Well, I think
mistake?
I would come clean. I think I would say, you know what, I feel terrible. I'm going to make you three loaves next week, and they're on the house. I know that's not much of a compensation, but I feel really bad.
I know, but you're all of a sudden like you own the place, or was this the person that owned the place?
Yeah, it was. She's the only employee.
That's something that they could have done for you then. Perfect.
Well, I think this so. Person. I mean, she said, is there anything? There was just, it was extremely half-hearted. Her, what? No way. It's, huh, this has never happened before.
She gets all Shatner on you.
Well, nobody's getting an acting award for this exchange. And I couldn't help it because my face went like this.
Oh, that's awesome. Oh, you did that, eh?
Yeah. Because it didn't land.
He gave her the tilt. Like, really? Is this like the Larry David looking in the eye? Like, are you not telling something that ain't
did
true?
Did it? And Carol and I, without saying much, kind of backed out of the store. No, I'm like, and we left. And she was like, you think... She is not telling the truth. And I was like, I do. I'm so gullible and naive that typically I would be the one that was like, oh, well, that is a weird coincidence, huh? But in this particular case, I was like, I don't know.
So then what? You just, yeah.
Well, we found, fortunately, Masstown Market has built a new creamery and butcher shop, and they carry this country sourdough. So we went out of our way to go home that way, and there was a loaf there. But it becomes a weird thing where, like, do we go back to the bakery now? It's for our kid, but I've been lied to, I think. Other thing I wanted to tell you, Jeremy, is that I'm back on the coffee.
When did that start?
Probably a week ago.
You said, like, did it happen in a situation where it was, like,
no.
a breakdown or just, like, I don't think this is anything. No. Let's just see.
It was as a direct result of people saying, how's it going? What, do you notice any difference? How's it going being off the coffee?
You know what? Go and fuck yourself. I'm here now.
Well, the truth is, there's no difference. I didn't feel any difference.
Like iced tea? Somehow that people found out he'd never tried coffee in his life? Or like,
is that
or
true?
A bagel or something. Something like a bagel and cream cheese he'd never tried. And then he's like, oh yeah, I've never tried coffee in my life. And then he put on Twitter him trying coffee for the first time.
Did he freak out?
It's really funny because he tries it black and he's like, man, this is garbage.
Why would people drink this?
And then he puts some sugar in and he's like, it's still awful. And then they put some cream, and he's like, well, hang on.
Now I get it.
Oh, okay. He's like, man, okay, now I can deal with this. I get this. This makes sense.
That was the thing. I didn't have headaches. I didn't actively miss it. I didn't crave it when I walked by a Starbucks. It was like, all right, I'm done with coffee. And then it was at the point where I was like, I don't know why I did that, because I'm not, I don't feel better. I didn't suddenly become jacked.
All of a sudden getting his best sleeps of your life.
It was nothing. None of that. I didn't feel refreshed. Loved ones have confessed since I'm back on the coffee that I was a little logy and a little lethargic when I was just drinking tea. I lacked the usual kick. Because, you know, I drink rocket fuel.
I love it. This is great.
Yeah, so I'm back on. But I proved to myself that I could do it.
Yeah. That's good.
And now I'm fired up. We should take a break.
Speaking of trying new things, this right here, my new mattress I'm trying.
What'd you get for a mattress?
It and this is no advertising anything. It's one of them purple mattresses. I just read it online to see which of those mattresses that you can get that would be best for your back and not the overdone memory foam whatnot.
So what
anyway,
is it?
It's been like 3 weeks and it's killer. No pain, no stiffness.
Did you have either of those things before?
Yeah, I was kind of getting consistent like arm, like my shoulder would be sore, or a leg would fall asleep. It's just the last mattress was just shitty mattress.
It was time. So what is the brand?
Purple. It's a king size purple mattress.
Because you hear people talking about those. What's the big deal about purple?
Well, because it's not just memory foam. It's got like kind of like a waffle vibe.
Girl, it's like okay.
It's like a horny Belgian waffle. It sounds like I'm talking like this is an ad, so it's
but it's not.
It's
Does not Lisa like it too?
Yeah. Yes, and she's had same thing, like no irritations whatsoever, like sleeping wise or kinks or anything.
Is it easy to roll around on the mat?
Yeah, and it's like one of those ones where if someone's jumping on one side, you don't feel it far away.
Right.
Like that. Yeah.
Sick.
Anyway,
mattress technology's come a long way.
Keep you updated. Keeping
Please
you all
do.
Updated on comfort.
Before we take a break,
yeah.
In a week's time, we're going to be in British Columbia. Nanaimo, Victoria, Vancouver, Penticton. We can't wait. Hopefully lots of bods got tickets as Christmas presents. And hopefully people have used the money they got for Christmas to buy tickets. We'd love to see you out there. And then at the end of February, we're in Alberta, Manitoba, and Saskatchewan. All the tickets and details are at taggartandtorrens.ca/tour. Hope to see you out there, buds.
Okay,
Before
buds,
we take
a
break, can I show you the Churro Bearcats logo?
I was waiting this whole time for it.
This segment of Taggart and Torrens brought to you in part by the Churro Bearcats. Welcome to the den. By request, we're going to play Hit the Post. People have been asking us to play Hit the Post in this new video format, and we haven't yet.
Yeah.
So, because of technology, we gave each other two songs to tee up, and
we haven't listened to them.
We should still give each other an animal and some call letters. Right?
Okay.
And a town.
Yeah. And a town?
Yeah.
Animal? Yeah.
Do you... Right. I'm going to give you one first. You ready?
Yeah. Sorry. Just in case. Got to keep it on the top of my brain. Yep.
94.5. The Wild Boar. And the town is Penticton. Right?
Yeah.
The boar. I don't know if that was a boar noise. And your song is How Will I Know by Whitney Houston. Careful, it's sneaky.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it going to jump at me? We'll see.
Yeah, do you want me to tee it up for you?
No. What do you mean?
Like throw like
In
it's a
regard?
Bumper. Like I'm a bumper. And now back to Jeremy Taggart.
Post, right?
On 94.5 The Boar in Penticton. Like one of those.
Oh, I didn't hear that. Sorry.
Okay, you ready?
Skipped out on my ear. Yeah, I'm ready.
You're listening to The Boar with everyone's favorite morning man, Jeremy Taggart.
Hey, everybody. How's your morning? How's it going? 94.5, The Wild Boar. Been ticking away. Oh, I miss her every time I hear her voice, but we're going to have a good time with old Whitney today. Whitney Houston, How Will I Know? On 194, The Wild Boar in Penticton, 94.5. Oh, she was beautiful, wasn't she? Here she comes. She's so beautiful, I wish she was back with us right now. I'd say hi. Hey, Whitney, how are you?
Okay. A few false bails, but I think overall that counts, doesn't it?
Yeah, I can.
Oh, I miss her so much. Every single day. I swear I miss her, I really do.
She sure was beautiful. You remember how beautiful she was? I was really, and then he tripped on the adding the 194.
What a beautiful gal. Yeah, I think that's a highway. I'm excited to see the Penticton of it all. And the Kelowna of it all. I've never been to that part of the province.
Yeah, I think I've only driven through, so it'll be nice to maybe had a pest there before.
You
on
must
a side
have,
stop.
You must have played have Kelowna, haven't you?
Yeah, oh yeah, many, many times. I think that's why we always played Kelowna.
Just never Penticton.
Never the Penty.
I'm excited.
We're gonna hit it. Okay, you ready for your first jam?
Yes.
Are you really?
Yes.
Because your first jam is Keep Feeling Fascination.
Okay.
And that's just such a classic jam. You're at the Otter.
Okay.
104.5 the Otter.
Okay.
And let's keep it out west, because everybody remembers the old days of the west, the first one. So let's take it back to Prince George.
Prince George, 104.5, yeah. The Otter. And the song is, yeah, Human League Fascination?
Yes.
I don't know this song very well. Okay, you ready?
Oh, it's a beauty. And it's a spicy jam. It's a good song to tap the toe to in traffic.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. 104.5. Hope you're not listening to any of those Otter stations when you have the Otter right here for all the 80s and 90s and mix of today. The one station everyone at work can agree on is Jonathan Torrens with you right now. Here's the Human League with Keep Feeling Fascination. Phone lines are open, looking for your requests. I'll let the Human League do the talking. Here they are.
Yeah!
Right?
For sure.
I had one
you
false fail.
No, it was good though. I mean,
do you
that's
ever hear false fails when you're in the car and you're like, oh, that doesn't really count? One false fail, but that's pretty good.
I don't hear talk-ups like I used to on the radio. You don't hear them like...
But, well, I also know from peeking behind the curtain,
you do once in a while.
They have a clock now. And they also they hit the post between songs and then just gear it up and roll it. So there's... The margin for error is a lot smaller.
It's real slim. It's real slim when you're just looking at that clock ticking.
Okay, so your next track is Skid Marks. I also know that if you do the 6 to 9 show, for example, you probably between 9 and 10 record all your hits for 9 to 12 so that it just goes on Robo Land, right?
Yeah, for sure.
In smaller markets?
Pre-recorded.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Your song is Endless Summer Nights by Skid Marks.
Okay.
Skid Marks. You should be in Nanaimo.
The Nines?
Nanaimo, okay. Yeah. And this hour is brought to you by Bar Nanaimo.
Okay.
That's good.
No ad and extra whatnot.
Okay.
What's the station?
The Muskrat.
Okay.
Let's say 99.9, the Muskrat.
Okay, 99.9?
Yeah.
Okay.
And now, back to Tagsy on 99.9, the Muskrat.
What's that? Oh! Hey everybody, how's it going? Holy moly, there's a bit of a traffic jam there in Nanaimo by the Boston Pizza. Richard Marx, remember old Richard Marx? I had a pretty good career, I think his uncommon, some bad tweets might have hurt his career lately. Seems to be one of those guys who says whatever he wants. You're listening to 99.9 The Muskrat Nanaimo.
Yeah! Yes, that was right in the pocket.
I snuck it in.
What happened with him?
I snuck it in there, just hoping.
I thought he was crushing the Twitter game. I thought his stuff was like, I'm still right here waiting. Like, I thought tweets like that.
I don't know. I was just riffing. That's a when you're reaching. I was hoping that there might have been
Cal riffing?
a controversial tweet out there from Richard Marx that...
There is a show on MTV, and I forget what it's called, but it's like rap against each other, and they pair unlikely bedmates to rap, freestyle against each other, but it's clearly written and whatever. And I saw one a couple weeks ago between Richard Marx and Kenny G. And those were two guys that I always they rapped against each other, and, you know, it was exactly what you would expect it to be.
Yeah.
But I think they both get who they are. Kenny G spits in Twitter fire too.
Kenny G does? No, yeah. He does not.
Yeah, he's funny.
No, he's not.
Yeah, he's really
he?
Funny.
Kenny G's funny.
Kenny G's funny. Have you seen The Masked Singer yet?
I'm trying to get his jam up here. That one, that classic. Where is it?
Well, how would you hit the post on Breathless?
You don't. You just kind of have it there, right?
And then you fade out.
I just want to remember how bad.
Are you changing my jam to Kenny G?
No, I'm just getting it set up for later. You go ahead. Your next jam is
Father Figure George Michael.
George Michael, Father Figure. Yeah.
Okay. What's my station?
And we could have you as a controversial new station in Richmond. Like trying to compete with Vancouver.
Okay.
And it's 94.9 The Voice, right?
Oh,
so it's
yeah,
real outspoken, and it's the new woke station in Vancouver.
Oh man. Oh no.
Well, maybe it should be woke 95.
Oh,
actually.
Oh man.
Woke 95.
Woke.
In Richmond.
Woke. Okay. And it's Father Figure?
Oh, this is great.
Woke
95.
FM. Okay.
I think we just created a whole new thing that I love.
Woke guy? Oh,
woke
man.
FM? All the different shows on Woke FM.
Oh, man. They're hashtag blast, right? Okay, you ready?
Okay, go.
Good morning. It's Jonah Hill Torrens on Woke FM. Aren't we lucky to be waking up in Richmond? Take a moment just to be hashtag grateful and hashtag blessed. Maybe you're sipping your latte. Maybe you've just finished Shavasana. But I know one thing's for sure. You don't identify as any gender in particular, and you're thankful to not be commuting into Vancouver this morning. The great thing about a song like Father Figure is that father can be whatever it means to you. It doesn't have to be a man. It just has to mean something. Here's George Michael. Yeah!
You crushed it.
Jonah Hill Torrens. I knew I should have a hyphenated last name. It probably should have been.
You got glasses that don't know prescription glasses.
Woke guy. Woke guy. There are a lot of woke guys around, aren't there?
I think I should do a woke guy.
You do a woke guy to Kenny G.
Like
Breathless.
Woke FM.
I'm going to hand over the reins to you. You're doing the lunchtime drive. But it's not called the drive. It's called the walk. or bus or bike. The lunchtime bike.
Okay, you want to get You can bring. Is it? What is it? It's Forever in Love, right? That's the jam.
Is it?
Isn't it? Or no? What's the jam called?
I'm gonna find the jam.
Whoa! This ain't it.
Songbird. Songbird. That's the jam.
Okay.
Kenny G, Songbird.
It's worth the wait, but it's such a bad song.
Kenny G, Songbird on Woke FM. It's perfect.
All right. Hey, everybody. It's your old buddy DJ Greg, Woke 95. Just enjoying a morning muffin with no butter, obviously. You know how we are. Being vegan is not something to be afraid of. Something we all should support and believe in. I was watching this Netflix documentary yesterday, Hold the Fork. It's about just living a sustainable lifestyle and finding your own way without taking too much. Because we all know we only have so much time before cataclysmic events right around the corner with glacial melting and climate change. I mean, what the hell are we doing here for anyway? I gotta go.
Greg is amped.
Hey, he's got a call-in show.
Do you want to do a
call-in show? What's going on out there? Woke up.
What's going on out there? What is even going on? Great, I get to be the callers for once. I love it. Are you ready, Greg?
Oh, we are? We're doing one?
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, should I get the jam back up?
For okay. Sure.
94.5 Woke FM phone lines are open. 1-800-GET-WOKE. Greg's on the line. Okay, we have Howard on the line. Howard?
Hey, Greg.
What's going on out there?
Just want to take a moment, man, to say, you know, I listen to you every day, and I just, you know, I feel a real spiritual connection to you, brother, and keep fighting the good fight, you know?
But not too spiritual, right? We know, you know, there's no God, right?
Well, I mean, I know that he or she is whatever we or he or they or them want it to be. And so I know on that level we both speak the same language. And I guess
we don't want each other. We don't want you wasting any time on those fairy tales out there.
Well, I know, but I guess I just wanted to deep down know, like in your heart, what do you think of spelt?
Spelt?
Yeah.
I love it. Put it on everything.
Cool, man.
Put it on everything.
Cool. Hey, listen, thanks for taking my call.
Hey, no problem. Okay, we have
cool.
Well, it seems we lost the call. We're gonna have to get him back here. We have another call on the line here.
Call rejected.
Hey, we have another caller on the line here. Oh, it seems that we may have to get him off the air. Let's get the music going up here a little bit. I'll get woke, and let's just all get woke together. Take a break on 94.5 Woke FM.
But here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take my next check, and I'm going to go to Money Mart, and I'm going to get her cashed, because the CNE's coming up soon, and I want to have money for that. No, it's not funny. I'm just living check to check right now. I don't even know where you get money, Laramie. Where's your money come from? Why are you laughing?
Hey, it's Woke Greg here, Woke FM, 94.5, Richmond's most awake citizens. Phone lines are open. What's going on out there? 1-800-GET-WOKE. We got a caller on the line. Camillo, you're on.
Greg.
Camillo,
Greg.
Yeah.
Man, it is such a great pleasure to speak with you.
Hey, man, no problem.
I don't want to bust your flow with this because it's been kind of bringing me down a lot. And I debated, should I call him? Should I not? Like, should I tie up phone lines? And what does that do to the environment? I am calling on my landline, you should know. So I'm not creating cell.
Cool. Well, again, we like all our callers to use landlines. We don't like cell phones.
Yeah.
Anyway, go on.
Right on. So I guess the reason I'm calling is because my sister has this kid. And
right there.
I mean, I know.
Having a kid, like, seriously?
I know, like with a flagrant disregard for, like, what is this kid's life even going to be?
Yeah. Okay. So they had a kid.
Yeah. There's no they. I mean, she did it alone.
Oh my, whatever. Yeah. Why not, right? Why not?
But that's neither here nor there. The reason I'm calling is because my sister has this kid, and she's had this kid for a couple of years, and my sister wants to throw this party for the kid.
Like, what do you mean? Like, what did the kid do? Like, did the kid achieve something? Or did the kid accomplish a goal? Or
Okay. By my standards, no. By her standards...
What are you talking about, man? What happened? What kind of idea? Like, why did they get... They have a celebration.
Okay, well, by my standards, no. The kid has accomplished nothing. Other than it still wakes up every day. By her standards... It is an anniversary of sorts because it was born around this time of year. And so she did this last year as well. And it's taken me about a year to get over it. But now the time is coming again where she wants to throw another party for this kid.
Oh, okay.
Yeah?
So like, boom, measurement of time, 1 year. Wow, yes. Everybody flatter me. Give me gifts because I'm so important because...
Are you invited?
Like, seriously.
Did you know? Because that is what she's doing. That everyone that comes has to bring some big piece of plastic and eat Dairy Queen cake on a plastic plate with cutlery and straws.
Like you're talking about birthdays, stupid birthday celebrations. Like, how do you even have a chance when this starts at 1? You don't even remember how old you are at 1.
Well, okay, yet so you've heard
this
of
big
these
party. Just on a measurement of time, man. How come I didn't get, like, a cake for, you know, going from 4'8" to 4'9", man?
Well, that's the
thing. What's that?
And I like to have fun as much as the next guy. I consider myself a pretty fun person. I like to have picnics on the beach, and I like to go for walks, and I like to clean up after myself, and I like to leave nothing but footprints, take nothing but however that goes.
Camilo.
You know what I mean? But please just let me recycle my thought.
I know, but we got to get on to the next caller, man.
I guess my thing is what it does is it creates an expectation that this two-year-old loser, he's a loser, still lives at home, doesn't contribute to the planet in any way.
Okay.
He expects to receive these mounds of plastic simply for existing.
I know. Okay. So thanks for calling, Camilo. Like, seriously, everybody, this is a problem. Like, birthdays, people celebrating continually every year for nothing. Appreciation for what, man? For nothing. Anyway, we have another caller. Roland, you're on.
Hello.
Roland, yeah, you're on, bud.
Greg?
Yep.
You talk a lot about ice flows and polar caps.
Yeah, and there's going to be a lot more ice flows and polar caps melting, I'll tell you that.
Have you ever been north of Richmond or Surrey?
Well... Not yet.
It's a yes or no question, so that's a no.
Well, no, I mean, the grouse grind.
Okay.
Like, I do that all the time, so...
Okay, did you study...
You know, like...
Did you study environmental issues or anything? I guess I'm just wondering what gives you the gumption to be an authority.
Well, I mean, doesn't take much, man. You go out and have yourself buy a soda at a store. And then say, I want to take this to go. And then what do you get it? You get it in a cup with a top of plastic on it and a straw in it.
Okay, but...
That just so you can enjoy a beverage, ice and cold beverage outside for $2. And then the enjoyment's gone when you finish that. And then that thing that's just sitting there is there for like eternity, man. That alone is enough to enrage me into doing my 3-hour show at Woke FM 94.5 for free every day.
But Greg, the thing of it is I listen to you every single day, and I listen to the things that you say, and I listen with an open mind, and I try to even live by some of them. But then every now and then it just occurs to me that you aren't really saying anything. You're telling us that you're woke, but you're not really. What is that? What is woke? What does that even mean?
It's woke, and obviously you don't. So I'll see you later. See you, Roland. Okay.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, I am woke. Figure it out. 94.5 Woke FM. I mean, we're gonna be going all night here, talking. I'm gonna tell you what it's like, and you gotta tell me what's going on out there.
So Greg works at 94.5 Woke FM for free, yeah. And he's on air all night?
He's on air all night.
Oh my God. Your sister coming home for Thanksgiving with Greg nightmare.
You know what he does for money? He sells chocolate-covered mushrooms on Rec Beach.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, he does. Woke FM.
He makes his own hacky sack.
And maybe inside.
Is that organic hacky sacks?
Gluten-free hacky sacks, and inside them is the chocolate-covered mushrooms. Greg.
Yeah, he doesn't wear a shirt from April to November.
And then he
has Birkenstocks only, and then he wears socks and Birkenstocks in the winter.
And in the fringe months, he wears a shirt, but it's not buttoned.
Yeah, he washes his hair in patchouli oil.
He looks like the mask from Sweating Bullets. Do you remember that show? It was a show about a perv with a ponytail and Hawaiian shirts and a Jeep who solved crimes in Hawaii, and he took down ladies.
I don't remember that.
He was like solving crimes and wheeling dimes. That was his whole thing.
When was that show on?
1990 something.
I missed it.
I can show you a picture of the guy.
I want to see it. What's the call?
Sweating bullets. Wait for it.
Good times.
I will describe it for the people that are watching or listening, not watching.
Yeah.
Sweating Bullets TV show.
Sweating Bullets.
And he also was sweating bullets because he lived in Hawaii. Yeah, there he is. There he is. Tropical Heat. Nick Slaughter was his name. Canadian.
Nick Slaughter.
Well, cheesy Canadian detective show. There you go. See it? Sweating Bullets.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. He was a handsome devil and irresistible to the ladies. That was his whole thing.
So he would it was like James Bond styles? Beginning
yeah,
it
was
the end of
sort
the
of in the...
It was him... Just finishing a date and I'm just about to start one at the end, one of those.
Yeah, and people were powerless to his gorgeousity, and he took everyone down. Yeah, that was it. I didn't know it was Canadian, though.
How come you don't remember the actor or anything?
Good question, because I don't know that he ever did anything since.
Interesting, to have like a leading role in Canada, but like nothing before or after.
I know, but do you ever think sometimes... It occurs to me that we haven't talked about huge things in Canadian pop culture. Not suggesting Sweating Bullets is one,
yeah.
But like the band Triumph. We've never really talked about that band on the show, have we?
Well, we've talked about Gil Moore a lot.
Oh, yeah, right.
Right.
So he was at your golf tournament, wasn't he?
Yeah, he's a bod. Yeah, I've played with him. He's a good guy, man. Love
good you. Golfer, too.
He's a great golfer. He's good friends with Tom Cochran. They're
there you go.
BFF golf buds.
They were in the same golf foursome, right?
Yeah, and didn't they win? Yeah, of course.
So Coxie said he was going to...
Coxie?
was going to invest in the Atlantic Schooners or whatever our CFL team bid is.
Oh, yeah.
Coxie's nice. Going to put down some coin. What kind of coin Coxie does Coxie have?
Here's a good example of what Coxie has done. He said that Rascal Flatts, when they did The Life is a Highway?
Yeah.
Like their version for the Cars movie, that the money he made off of just that one was more than he'd ever made on everything combined.
Wow.
Plus. And it's just a continual. That wow. You know, and that, but that's a classic song. It'll probably get covered again now. You know what
so
I mean?
So what kind of dough? What kind of dough would that be?
Millions, man.
Man.
Millions.
But you know what the craziest part of it is?
For him. Actually, apparently, Boy Inside the Man is in some movie coming up too. That would be nice. That's a
as it should be. That gets you fired up.
Yeah.
Life is a highway too. That's the thing of it.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we should do again sometime. We should play in the booth where we have to lay down legit vocal takes of some of your favorite songs. Do you want to do that?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, like the takes of the bits?
Yeah.
Like, you have to do the musical part?
Yeah, yeah. Well, you have to sing it, and you have to mean it. Acapella. Well,
yeah.
Okay, let's take a break. We'll play some In the Booth.
In the Boosky.
BRB, buds.
Ba, ba, ba. That orange
one. Phil.
Yeah.
Happy New Year to you, first of all.
Happy New Year, Donovan.
But enough with the pleasantries. You're probably wondering why I have invited you to come to the studio on such short notice.
I have, actually.
Okay. Between you and me and the Green, I have been contracted to come up with ringtones for cell phones. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So imagine, if you will, you had friends and one of them called you, a hypothetical already, I know. But imagine when your phone rang instead of a standard ring, yeah? What if it was the start of your favorite song? So what we're going to do is create a catalog of riffs of people's favorite songs, and I thought, instead of paying a band, yeah, why wouldn't I just bring you?
Phil.
As I recall, you owe me a favor or two. Yeah?
Well, I mean...
Great. So here's what we're going to do.
Joey Kramer beat me up.
Mike's not working. Can't really hear anything.
At a barbecue again because you... That stuff that you made me play on Living on the Edge that you said that he wanted me to
yes,
do.
Oh, yes, of course.
Yeah.
You and Joey.
Yeah, man.
The greatest love story of all time.
He said, I'm going to throw you in the bonfire, and he beat me up, man.
He said what?
Yeah.
He said what?
So, I owe you a favor.
Joey Kramer, what are you?
Come on, Donovan.
Here's what we're going to do, Phil. Do you know the song Power of Love? Not by Celine, but by Huey Lewis.
Yeah.
Do you know the music of Huey?
I did, yeah.
Yeah, the H is silent. Huey Lewis.
Yeah, apparently has a pretty big hammer, too.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you know...
As it documented in the movie Shortcuts.
Really? Someone should make a documentary.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
So, Phil, we're going to do The Power of Love for those 80s babies... that still fancy themselves Michael J. Fox in Back to the Future. So, do you remember? Zhoop-bop, doogie-doogie-doop-bop. Let's start with, can you do the riff but also the drums? I'm recording. Are you saying snow snow?
I was, yeah.
Can you try it?
Snap, stop, pop.
Just try it with plow, plow.
Pla, plu, pla, pla, plu, pla. Boop, boop, to pla, pla, pla.
Just the plow, plow, so, 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 plow, plow, no, now, now, now.
Plow, do, plow, da, do, plow, plow, do, do, plow, plow.
Yeah, but more of a plow, plow, so, 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 now, now, meow, 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 like a meow.
Plow, plow, meow, 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 meow.
No, don't squander the meow. Save the meow. So, plow, plow, now, 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 sow, sow, meow, 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 meow.
Plow, plow, meow, 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 plow, plow, meow, 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 meow.
That's closer, yeah?
Plow, plow, chow, be, chow, meow, meow, plow, meow, 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 meow.
I feel like you said chow, chow, like the dog.
Chow, chow, chow.
Yes,
chow,
exactly.
Chow.
Don't do that.
Chow, 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 bow, 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 low, chow, pow.
Can you try bow, wow, and then the meow, meow?
Like I kind of feel like I'm losing my mojo here,
just,
man.
Trust me, when you're losing your mojo, it's when you're on the verge of something extraordinary. Just try.
Oh, no, man.
Just listen to me. Plow, plow, bow, wow, meow, meow. Oh, I got it now. Try that.
But I'm not supposed to... I don't sing words, though, man. Those are words. I don't plow, meow.
But the thing is, I don't pay your check unless you do another song? What I need.
Can we do another song and come back to this, man?
Fine. Welcome to the Jungle. Do you know that song?
Yeah, man.
Can you try that song?
Remember that time Matt Sorum pushed me around? Remember that? Because of your illusion, you brought me in.
Well, that's the thing of it. It was my illusion that they used.
November Rain, remember that?
Yeah, November Rain. Who knows November Rain more than people from England? November Rain in California.
Those big drum fills, that those bra boom, bra ba boom. That's, you didn't even pay me for it because you didn't tell him. And then I told somebody drunk at a party, and then he found out. And then he realized, and I did it live in front of people, and he was really embarrassed, man.
Well, how do you think I feel? They used my illusion. Yeah?
But yeah, I didn't get paid, though. So, like, that was a pretty big album. I think that sold, like, 25 million.
But you don't do it for the money. You do it for the love. Like my relationship with the Queen. I don't have lunch with her because she pays every single time. I don't do it for the Range Rovers she gifts me every Christmas.
All right. I'm just gonna do the guitar intro then, man.
Okay, but take a big breath because I can't hear a single breath. Pretend my phone's ringing, and I want it to inspire me to say hello. And if I do say hello, you stop mid riff because we want it to sound pure. Hello. That's pretty good, yeah? That wasn't bad.
That worked out, man. Welcome to the Jungle ringtone.
Do you know, do you remember when they play at the sporting events? It's like Gary Glitter.
You mean, Gary Glitter? No, you mean like
Boopy Doo Doo Yay! No.
Oh, that.
Boopy Doo Doo Yay! Hurrah!
Yeah, I think so.
That
yeah.
one. Can
Creepy
you
Gary Glitter? Yeah.
Can you record something like that for me? Can you try
like
a little less Louis Armstrong, a little more Tickle Me Elmo? Do you know what I mean? That's good, yeah? I could imagine myself answering the phone with that kind of noise. Do you know sexual healing?
Something like that?
That's actually, that's quite good. Were you stimulated while you did it?
I was just kind of visualizing like the sound of a ball hitting a squash cork.
It sounds really good, as a matter of fact. Do you know, under my thumb?
Yeah.
Can I hear that riff, please?
For some reason, I only got the vocal in my head, the melody.
It would be remiss of me, in conclusion, not to get you to do just the drum solo from In the Air Tonight, because I know people have asked, could I have that as my ringtone? And it'd be nice to provide them with that.
I know, but you remember last time when I did that, and then Phil Collins came at me at the Rainbow, man. Like, you know, he's not that tall, but if he's like coming at you, like bull rushing, he took me right down because of that.
He looks a bit like a penis, yeah?
Well, he acts a lot angles. Like one, too, if he's coming at you.
Really?
You gotta watch out.
Phil's harmless. It depends if he's on the
gap. He's bull rushing you, man. Like, back when he was doing Miami Vice, he was rough, man.
Is Miami Vice some type of drug?
No, remember when he was on Miami Vice?
Oh, yes, of course, of course, of course.
Weren't you on Miami Vice?
Oh, the drug, indeed. I was, yeah. Hey, I've been watching this Beatles documentary that Ron Howard made. And he's cobbled together some of the greatest footage from behind the scenes and in front of the scenes and so much context.
See how wicked it sounds? Ringo just keeping the time with no monitors. They can't hear each other at all. And
well,
Ringo's
especially
just keeping it together.
Shea Stadium.
Yeah.
He's looking at Paul's head to try to figure out where they are in the song. Well,
and they can hear him only. That's it. They can't hear each other themselves. They're just kind of going by the you know, playing it a million times, but just being kind of connected with that.
Unreal. And so used to playing together in small clubs and everything, right?
I mean, maybe the best band of all time, because the footage sounds like as if they can hear each other.
And I also didn't know.
That was consistent, but nobody played to that amount of people, so that's why it's ridiculous.
They were also broadcasting, or they didn't have a PA, right? It just went through the now batting number 72.
That was it. The announcer PA. That was everything went in there. So the crowd couldn't hear anything. Like when my mom saw the Beatles in 64 and at Maple Leaf Gardens, she couldn't hear anything. Just screaming.
They sold out two nights in a row.
Yeah.
Look how dark I am now because the sun has started to go down.
You're not that dark.
Aaron's going to have fun with this one, man.
Good time spots.
Hey, special thanks to our little girls for doing the tease in this episode.
Oh, yeah.
What a nice way to start this episode with the girls.
Yeah, can't wait.
Do the drum fill from In the Air Tonight just as a way to say goodbye. That is tight. See you next week, bud.
Bananas are potassium. Bananas are yellow. Bananas,
bananas come in bunches. Sometimes there's tarantulas in them. But